when people use the word aqeedah, there's so much confusion in Muslim world, you cannot imagine really. Very often people mean aqeedah, as I mentioned really so many times, they mean aqeedah in the meaning of identity and belonging. If you don't belong to the same group as I belong, then you have different aqeedah. So many people say that, you know, I am Deobandi, and you are not Deobandi, so you have different aqeedah from me. Ask the people what is Deobandi aqeedah. They don't know. Just imagine, and do ask them, do the Deobandi have only one aqeedah, or there are differences among themselves, them as well? You know, people have made up many mistakes. If you go deep and deep really, people have no idea what they're talking really. Aqeedah does not exist anywhere. Nobody can define aqeedah. Nothing there anyway. What is Deobandi? What is Barelvi? What is Salafi? What is Athari? What is Ashari? What is Maturidi? You cannot define these terms really. Every Ashari is different from the other. You know, Abul Hasan Ashari, he did not say things which Ghazali and Imam al-Harman have developed. You don't find his books. If you read his books, I have read his books, I know that they are different. People actually have no idea. There is no single approach for anything. You know, even somebody says I'm Ashari, don't think there is some simple definition of Ashari people and he fits in that. Ashari people among themselves, they have so much differences, you can't imagine really how many there. And Maturidi people, they have so much difference among themselves, you cannot imagine how many differences there are really. Because the thing is, because these are belongings, and when you make aqeedah as belonging keeps changing. Because I think really, a true Muslim is the one who has, you know, topi on the head. If you don't have topi, you are not on my aqeedah. That's what people think. Many people in India think if you do the prayer without topi, you have different aqeedah. They think you have different aqeedah. You see, because I have seen all my life people praying with the topi becomes part of the aqeedah. That's how many people think. Don't go for this thing. Actually, and I'll inshallah come that what problem actually aqeedah has created for the Muslim ummah. The only thing is iman and amal. Nothing is there really. Read the whole Quran, read the Sunnah, read the biography of the Prophet. This word aqeedah has never come anywhere. Aqeedah word is not part of the Quran. Is it in the Quran? Has Quran ever discussed what aqeedah means? Has hadith ever said what aqeedah means? If something is not in the Quran and in the hadith of the Prophet, if the Prophet did not teach us to have aqeedah, why we are insisting on so much anyway? And then we think if somebody does not have aqeedah, as I have, he becomes kafir. You know, it really has no proof. Islam had only iman and amal. Islam never had any aqeedah, any kalam, any theology. They are not part of Islam. Islam has iman. Islam is religion of the people who do something, not religion of the people who discuss things and debate things and do nothing. Not the religion of the lazy and, you know, coward people. Religion of the people who work hard. Religion of the people who want to sacrifice their desire for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The religion of the people who want to do slavery. Islam means slavery of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You become, he is the master and I am the receiver of the command. I do what he wants from me to do. I don't care about my comfort, my family, my anything. I do what he wants from me to do. That's what Islam actually is. So you see, if you look in the Battle of Badr, you know what happened to that, you can see what Islam really is. In the Battle of Badr, Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, you know, he is from the believers. And his father, you know, Al-Jarrah, he is from the among unbelievers. Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he killed his father with his own sword. Can you imagine that? Ibrahim al-Islam was commanded to slaughter his son, but that did not happen. Here is somebody, why? Because that person was an unbeliever. Now when you fight, he's enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If somebody is enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I cannot leave him, whether he's my father or my son, or no matter, you know, relation I have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is actually thing. Abdul Rahman in Abi Bakr, the son of Abu Bakr was from among unbelievers in Baitul Badr, and Abu Bakr Siddiq was from the believers. Later on, when Abdul Rahman became Muslim, he said to his father, "Oh my father, in the Battle of Badr, it happened 3 times that you came under my sword, and I did not kill you because you were my father." Abu Bakr Siddiq said to him, "Oh my son, had you been under my sword only once, I would have killed you because you were enemy of Allah and His Messenger." You know, become slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, see that I don't have any will, I don't have any intention, I don't have any desire. My will is under the will of my Lord. Whatever He commands me, I do that. That what then Allah loves you. That what He wants from you. You know, He does not enjoy our problem. It's not like that Allah is someone, you know, who enjoys the problem. Like there are people among your friends, when you have problem, they enjoy that. They're happy when you have. Allah is not like that, you know, when I have suffering, He enjoys that. No, Allah wants to train us. To make us a superhuman being, that, you know, we are ready to have every problem, but still we are firm. You know, that is a big thing. You are hungry, but still you want to do the prayer. you have problems, you have lost your family, you, everybody, but still you actually believe in Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He wants to train us, he wants to refine our character, he wants to make a better human being, he wants to make us better than angels. So then he, you know, he can show to angels, these are the human beings, you did not like them, and they're better than you, these people. That's what Islam actually is. Islam makes people better than the angels. And when people go to the desires, they, you know, they become worse than the animals. Come sacrifice the desires and come to the Islam. Islam is sacrificing the desire for the command of Allah.